So these are our individual calves, and they come out here when they're 3 days of age and are raised individually in a calf-tail hutch until they're 90 days of age. We're using 90 days for this little study here. We've tried many different weeks. We'll probably settle on 9 weeks or 63 days of age for our future studies. But they come out here and we use a individual peach teat feeder with a nipple on it that we place on the pen. And our calves will hopefully come out. And we feed them 4 liters, about a gallon in the morning and a gallon at night. And our calves are doing quite well out here. They're growing about 2.1 pounds per day in an individual hutch. Once our calves have hit 90 days for this project, they come into group housing and we mingle them all together. So there's a wide range of calves from the different systems in this hutch. Some of them have been raised on our automatic calf feeder and we're getting ad lib, so as much milk as they wanted. This big Holstein here in front has been fed ad lib, so she's been drinking about 14 to 18 liters per day when she was weaned. Some of the other calves came out of our individual hutch and they're maybe a little bit smaller, just fed 8 liters, which is still a lot of milk, but obviously the more milk that these calves are fed, the more growth that we get. However, we still need to do the economics on that to see if feeding more milk is actually worth it in the end. But they do grow nice calves, nice big calves, when we're fed ad lib on the auto feeder compared to the individual hutches. These are the oldest calves that we have weaned off of our project. These calves were born in late March and early April. So they're about 4 months of age right now. This little friendly one here, she was raised in an individual hutch. She was our first calf in the individual hutch. She was growing about 2.4 pounds a day at weaning. And yes, she is quite friendly. Some of the other calves that are in this pen were weaned off of our automatic calf feeder at over 300 pounds. Some of them were being fed ad libitum. And they were drinking 16 to 18 liters of milk in 1 day. So a calf will consume a lot of milk. However, they do consume less grain when they're being fed all of that milk. So we do feed grain to our calves. When they come out here after weaning, we feed them grain as well as we start feeding them alfalfa hay to keep them growing into the future. So this is our automatic calf feeder. We have a Holman Lau calf expert that we use. There are many different types of feeders. We have settled on this one because we like the cleaning aspects of it and we're able to feed 4 calves at one time. How this works is our calves come onto the auto feeder at 4 days of age. They can come into these individual stalls where they're recognized by the computer and we can set different feeding amounts for these calves. In the past, we have looked at feeding calves 8 liters per day or ad libitum. So we can set this feeder to feed as much milk as we want. Throughout our study, we have found that feeding calves ad libitum off of the calf feeder has a lot of growth potential. They grow a lot. We can feed them to over 300 pounds at 8 weeks of weaning. In the feeder room here, we have the stalls. So these are the individual stalls that the calves are recognized with their RFID in their ear. This is our calf feeding system that allows the dispensing of milk. We can also look at a lot of information from these calves, and it's also hooked to the internet where we can look at our smartphone and we can look up what calf we want to see and see how much milk she has consumed during that day. A unique feature about this system is it also records the birth weight. So we have a partial weight scale on the stall. So every time a calf comes in, it takes a weight of that calf. So So we maybe in the future be able to use the weights from the stalls to measure our calves' growth instead of physically doing that. We've looked at research that validated these stalls, and it's quite accurate at 95 to 99% accuracy. Comparing the weight from an individual scale that we've weighed to the stall weight. We feed whole milk in our automatic feeding system, so we have this bulk tank, 250-gallon bulk tank, that we're able to cool the milk for the auto feeder. The feeder then heats the milk up to 101 degrees to dispense to the calf. A milk taxi to feed all of our calves. This milk taxi is a pasteurizer as well, so we can pasteurize the whole milk to feed to our calves. We can also feed it to our individual calves, and it will dispense the exact amount that we need to feed to our calves. So if we're feeding 4 liters in the morning, we can dispense exactly 4 liters to those calves with our milk taxi. So these are our stalls that the calves come in on the automatic calf feeder, where they can come in as many times as they want during the day. That doesn't mean that they're going to get milk every time that they come into the stall. It depends on what feeding program that we have them set at. So they come in the stall, are recognized with the reader with their RFID tag, and the weigh scale is on the stall as well, where we record the body weight of the calf every time it comes onto the scale. These stalls are also cleaning stalls, so every time a calf comes in and backs out, it will send a cleaning solution to the nipple, so it's a clean nipple every time a different calf comes into the stall. The pen here, we typically have about 2 pens where we feed about 20 calves per pen to maintain our size of our calves. We don't want big calves with little calves, so we make pens. Potentially, we could make up to 4 pens, with each having 1 individual stall per pen. Into the future, we hope to do more automatic calf feeder research and maybe one day have all of our calves on a feeding program. Another unique calf raising experiment that we're doing is raising calves on cows on pasture. So in the background we have 8 cows that are raising their calves from birth until weaning at 90 days of age. The calves have been growing quite well. It's almost like we've been ad libitum feeding them, like we saw in the calf feeder. These calves are being weaned at 90 days of age, and some are doing very close to 3 pounds of gain per day. But they come out here during both the daytime and the evening hours and can drink from mom when they want. The cows are also milked twice a day, so we actually bring the cows and calves up to our holding area, to the milking parlor, and milk the cows. Most of the cows right now, when the calves are a little bit older, are only milking maybe 5 to 10 pounds a day. Some don't even have any milk when they come into the milking parlor. We've weaned 6 calves off the cows as of right now. Those calves grew the best out of any of the calf raising systems that we had. They grew about 2.75 pounds per day. We don't know what those calves were drinking for milk, because it's hard to tell what they were drinking from mom when they were able to drink as much as what they want. However, the 6 cows that we have weaned off the calves, they're back into production now. Some of them are milking about 20 pounds a day. Some have been up to 35 pounds of milk per day. And those cows are roughly 100 days in milk right now. So they're starting to come back into production after they've been feeding their calves throughout the experiment. these are the 8 calves that have been weaned so far that were raised off of their moms. And these calves are about 3 to 4 months of age, so they're just weaned a couple weeks. They did really good from a growth perspective, did about 3 pounds per day off of mom. So here we're trying to adjust them to eating some forage as well as grain. They didn't eat as much grain when they were raised off of the cow, but we're trying to get them more accustomed to the human interaction. You can see they're kind of a little skittish behind me, so we're gonna look at ways to help alleviate fear from raising on mom and have more human interaction. This project was sponsored by the Organic Valley Farmers Advocating for Organics Fund. So we sincerely appreciate their funding for this pilot study that we did to raise calves on cows.